Hey guys, it's Zach with Blade HQ, and we're here at SHOT Show 2018, and we are at the Kizer booth. I'm sitting here with David from Kizer, and he's going to run us through some of these awesome pocket tools and different cutlery things that I have going on this year.
All right, thank you, Zach.
Yeah, thanks for having us.
Hey, everybody.
I'll start from the left to the right-hand side. First, we have the dead fish. It's an odd name, but the Picaron design has always used the marine pointillo for all his designs. And as you can see, this one is a very compact keychain too. You got your cap twister for those twist off. Then you got your cap lifter. Then you got your little pry bar right here. Then you have a nail puller and a couple straight ahead screwdrivers. This one is your hex bit driver. Of course, everything in titanium. Comes in both in plain and anodized blue. That's a dead fish. Next up, also in very compact form, we have the talon pry. You have your little finger ring here. Make sure you never lose it. Your little key ring right here. Your hex driver right here. Little your pry bar, hence the name, the talon pry. And of course, has become a very common, always have a bottle opener with you, no matter where you go.
Yeah, let's see that one. Yeah, this is, I really like the design on this one, just how compact that is there. That one's really cool. Yeah, that's a really good one. And with that finger there, that's also a good way to get the pry on the bottle
as well. Get your little torque going.
Exactly, yeah, no, that's really neat.
Now you got the bottle opener going, you got your beer open. How do you get your buddy to come join you? You got your whistle right here.
Whether you're drinking beer or Coca-Cola, right?
Exactly.
Call all the friends over.
You want to get a party going. 120 decibels in this little whistle right here. Easily attached to your keychain right here. And of course, comes with its own bottle opener. Now, all the details on this whistle, as you can see, are hand ground.
Yeah, that's something that's impressive. We were talking about, we'll get over to here, some other things that are hand ground. You were saying that when you were visiting the Kizer factory that you saw a guy there actually.
Yeah, yeah. Well, not just one guy, obviously.
Right, yeah, obviously, yeah, just guys right
this,
there.
It's
hand
all
grinding
by
everything.
Hand. So
that's
we cannot make two whistles or two chopsticks the same, even if we wanted to.
Right, exactly. That's awesome.
So for this one, it's very new. It's called Pakari, little wild pig. All steel, so it will stand up to any abuse you have. You have your hex driver right here. When you buy those two, there's going to be a metric version and a standard version, so you can fit any screws you need to. Your little keychain right here, screwdriver, your nail puller, and your little pry bar, your little bottle opener right here, and this one's a scraper.
Oh,
you
awesome,
want to get rid
yeah.
of the paint residue or anything, just
yeah.
scrape it off. And of course, a chunky piece of steel.
Yeah, that was something that I noticed with this one is they all feel really great, but with the steel, it kind of has a little bit of heft to it.
Oh yes, yeah, definitely.
Yeah, this is definitely like, throw it on the keychain and this thing can take some abuse for
this
sure.
This will, you know, this little piggy will take a lot of abuse. It will not be blown away. And this one, a very unique piece, it's called the Pry Axe by our designer in Florida. And based on the battle axe from the Middle Ages, as you can see, you got your little nail puller right here on the top, little pry bar. You got your little screwdriver at the end, and you got your hex driver bit holder on both ends.
Yeah.
And there's actually a different hex bit holder at the bottom of the edge of the axe.
Cool.
And on the top end as well.
Awesome.
So it's a very unique design. And this one will definitely attract attention no matter where you pull it out.
For sure. Now I'm seeing the edges here have some detail. Is this also a hand grind on the edges here?
Or
is
this that one is a hand finish.
Hand finished, cool.
Hand finished.
Awesome.
And of course, you know, when you've done all the drinking you need, America's favorite pastime, baseball. Titanium baseball bat with a glass breaker, you know, just in case.
Yep.
And here is the keychain too, a keychain ring, so you can always have it with you no matter where you go.
Yeah, when we pulled up, me and Jamie, the video guy, we were both really excited about this one. It's just really fun. There's just something fun about it. And a lot of times, things that go on my key ring or my pocket, they're like, they're very specific tools. But like this is, I feel like I would just have this because it's just fun. I love it. You know,
either crack of the bat, rile the crowd.
Yeah, exactly.
This is when springtime comes.
Yep,
and you get out there and enjoy the sun and the fun.
I love it.
All right. Now you've done all the sun and fun, let's go to where you get your meals done. So what meal can be complete without your classic spork? So we call it our fest. Here's your little spoon, your fork, and our bottle opener. Now the short version comes with a screwdriver at the end.
Awesome.
Now this one doesn't specifically have a knife because we figure we're Kizer. We got knives plenty.
Yeah.
there's always a knife handy, no matter where you are. So of course, everything is made in titanium. You see? Now that's a short and easy to carry one. And then we have a full-size vest for you right here. A separate spoon, but there's also a spork at the end. There's a bottle opener in the middle with a fairly heavy construction so they will stand up to the pressure.
Yeah, I like that a lot. I think, so this one here, I have a really great friend and he always has a spork in his pocket. He's got a knife in his pants pocket and a spork in his breast pocket. And something like this, I feel like he would really love with the bottle opener and the spork. And this is great just kind of for general use. But this here, I've found personally that I've got a couple Thai sporks from a couple different companies. And they tend to be either really skinny or not long enough that when I'm making they've got a lot of meals in bags, you just add the hot water.
Right.
When I'm backpacking, it's not long enough to get down in there. And really, I feel like you can really, there's some length to this. And it's got some purchase so that you don't lose the spoon down in the bag.
I agree completely because I carry a lot of MREs with me when I go camping.
Exactly, exactly.
And the MREs usually are opened up on the narrow end so that when you gotta really dig down deep.
Yep.
So one thing I did, I started opening on the wide end.
There you go. I like it. That's a great trick. I love it.
Now you got your a Western lean on the utensils, but we are a Chinese company, probably made in China. Here we go. This is our version on the oldest eating tool, the chopsticks. Titanium chopsticks, anodized differently to suit your personal taste. And as we mentioned, every piece of the chopstick, every surface is all hand ground. So no two chopsticks are the same.
Yeah, it's so neat. And I don't know if you guys can see this on camera very well, but it really is just the variation here is just really, really neat. And I actually have a pair of chopsticks, Thai chopsticks, that they're in half and you can screw them together.
Right, that's probably gonna be our next project where
that's awesome.
Get something a little compact for the camping crowd.
Yeah, I like that. But one problem I have personally with those, the ones that I have, is that you can't grip them as well. And with these, you really get a really great grip with that grind in
and
there.
I'm
it
sure
feels awesome.
It doesn't show up on the camera very well because they're very detailed.
Yeah.
You can see there are grooves at the end of the chopstick.
Yeah.
So when you try to pick up your more slippery things, they will help a lot in getting them picked up.
And for somebody who doesn't use chopsticks all the time, I actually appreciate that a lot.
And when you buy the chopsticks, we'll give you this waterproof aluminum container that opens up on both ends.
Yeah.
So you essentially have a waterproof container for anything else you might need for your camping trip.
Yeah, I love that. That's great.
Once you're done with your meal, but you got a little thing stuck, or you know, some little annoyance, here we come with the finisher of the meal. A waterproof container for your battery, for your pills, for your money, whatever you might need. But you open it up.
Ooh. Hey, that was butterfinger.
But that's okay. It's aluminum, it won't break. Titanium toothpick. A tiny little thing with an easy to grip handle right there. And this will put away a lot of the little worries you have.
Yeah. The end piece here is a really great design because it gives you really good purchase. And on top of that, that tip is really nice and sharp. Not dangerously sharp. Like, I wouldn't be scared to put it in my mouth. Like, some of the knives are very, very sharp. But it's got a good point to it that really, if you need to get in there, you can.
Get into little crevices,
exactly.
Get those things out.
Exactly. Which is, just great. I love that a lot. I think it's a great little feature. Awesome. Well, these are some really awesome pocket tools and some really fun eating options here that I really like.
2018 is the year that we decided to explore that everywhere carry. So instead of everyday carry, you can carry every day, but these are things you can carry no matter where you go.
Love it.
They're innocuous, you won't raise any eyebrows, but you'll find many uses for them matter where you are.
No, I love that. And I love that both of these come with the holding utensil, or the holding piece. You don't have to buy it separately. I think that's a great touch.
Utility is where we're striving for.
I love it.
And we're hoping to get more utility into these however we can.
I love it. Awesome. Well, thanks for having us at the booth.
Thank you very much.
Appreciate it. And if you guys want to see what David's carrying in his pocket, make sure to check out our Kizer. They've got a bunch of new knives as well. We've got a video for that out as well.
We'll see you there.
That's all we've got from the Kizer booth, but that's not all Blade HQ has for you guys. Make sure to check out our 2018 SHOT Show playlist, and I'm sure there'll be something awesome. And Kizer has some really awesome new knives they're offering, so make sure to check that video out as well.